You can see that these giant sulfide towers that are formed by the precipitation of minerals from these hydrothermal vent systems create a real navigational challenge on the seafloor.
And temperatures right at that vent, for those of you guys tuning in, can reach 600 degrees Fahrenheit, so it's very hot.
As it comes into contact with the cold seawater, the mineral load carried dissolved or partly dissolved in those fluids is very rapidly precipitated, and those minerals have a very dark color, black color, primarily iron sulfide with perhaps some copper and zinc sulfide in there.
There you go.
Grip lock is on. Okay, so let's see what happens.
There you go.
I feel like I'm actually warming up physically.
Yeah,
like
I'm just take our jackets off.
I'm like sweating.
We've got 324.1.
Oh,
will
man.
It get any higher? 324.2.
Two.
Three.
Hit 321.
Oh!
326!
I can't believe it.
Can you believe it, folks?
I can't believe what I am seeing.
That smaller little chimney to the left of the lasers, that might be some sulfide worm colonies, a more active, hotter area. I'm seeing a scale worm over on the right side, that white, scaly worm.
Just don't knock it over, Bob.
This one looks pretty sturdy. So.
Yeah. Just don't knock it over, Bob.
So yeah, you can see some palm worms in the shimmering water. Rigia.
There you go.
With the bright, the kind of foamy or hairy looking brush-like plumes. Yeah. It's kind of a textbook, beautiful view of diffuse flow and some focused flow. Yeah, there's some sulfide worms there. You're seeing lots and lots of limpets. Probably a lot
on top
cooler
of the chimneys, right,
right
yeah.
behind
no,
that triangle. And you've got some pretty healthy looking Rigia.
Look at the shiny pyrite there.
And then as the A team's done here, we'll have somebody else come in and recover for us.
Yep. Is that the ROV equivalent of a mic drop?
Not really. We drop enough stuff.